guys, and welcome back to my channel. If this is your first time here and you're into 3D printing, photography, drones, tech, and whatever interests me, start now by subscribing and hitting the bell so you won't miss anything. Today we're gonna take a deep dive into a three-year-old 3D printer. It's been on the market for 3 years, but at the moment it's at 50% of the original cost, which is a crazy bargain. I'm talking about the FLSun SR Super Racer. It's a Delta 3D printer, as you can see, and it's kind of amazing. It's my first Delta. I mean, this was my first time with a Delta, and I must say it's amazing. But let's roll the intro first and let's talk about it. FLSun SR Super Racer Delta 3D printer. As you can see, not a brand new 3D printer. It's been on the market for the last 3 years. But why am I reviewing this? I'm reviewing this because currently it's at half price. That means 250 euros at the moment on the market. I don't know, probably you'll find coupons to add to that link at the same time. All the links, by the way, will be down in the description. Unboxing and putting together took not more than 15 minutes. I was impressed by the number of spare parts included in the package. That's awesome. And from what I recall, it never happens. The SR is a big printer, as you can see. It's like very, very tall. And it feels really, really sturdy. One of the first things I loved about this 3D printer is the auto leveling. I mean, I did that once. I've been printing with this printer for the last months. I never had to calibrate and re-level the bed. And I moved it from one side to the other here in the studio, like to do shots, to take some videos and stuff like that, and I never had to re-level it. And the leveling is like pretty much easy. You use a spare part that like you mount underneath with a magnet, and then you run the command, as you see you're seeing right now. Don't forget to take it off, because otherwise if you start printing with that on, I don't know why the software doesn't recognize it, you're gonna end up scratching the plate. I nearly did that. I like, just like took it off while it was moving. I just realized it was mounted on and took it off. If you pay attention, printer is on. I mean, of course it's just a cooling fan, but it's a pretty quiet 3D printer. The only thing you hear is the extruder over there. I mean, it's not the best extruder on the market. Don't forget, it's like 3 years old. I mean, you can do an upgrade to it, but it does its job. I mean, it's not that noisy. Something else that I love is this touchscreen that you can like bring with you, look at. It's touchscreen. And as far as I recall, I've never seen such a well-made touchscreen on a, let's say, budget 3D printing printer, because we're talking about a budget 3D printer, because the price is currently half of the original, as I said. One thing that I didn't like out of the box is the spool holder up here. As you can see, I had to print this. I had to print this piece because the original one is kind of flimsy. And you find this print online, it's very easy print. And it just goes in place like this, and then it holds your larger spools as well, and it works perfectly. So like an hour and a half print, and we fixed the only problem that I found while I was putting it together. Let's have a look at some specs. Speed is claimed to be 150 millimeters per second right out of the box, and it's great that you can see real-time speed on the display as it prints. It's the first time I've seen this on a 3D printer. Volcano style hot end and great cooling system make this printer a complete beast. Now let's get on the juicy parts, and I want to show you the prints I've done. First thing out of the box, I printed out this Benchy. It was sliced by FLSun. It was on the SD, so I'm not responsible for the slicing. As you can see, there's a little bit of stringing. Probably they pumped up the temperature in order for it to flow so fast, because it printed out in like half time, two thirds of the regular time that a normal 3D printer does. But overall, it came out nicely. I mean, it's a nice Benchy. I mean, I've printed worse one. PLA, I know it was working fine. I wanted to test this printer on a larger print, on something important, something full of details. And over on Cults, I found this model and I fell in love with it, and I decided to buy it. Here you go. I mean, it's not still together. It was printed in two pieces, as you can see. It's a great model. It's supposed to be a dice tower, but it's blocked on the inside. And guys, I'm really loving this model. And as you can see, print results are great. The only issue I found was here at the end of the print, where I pumped up the temperature right from the control while it was printing. I was afraid it was gonna jam because it was pushing really, really hard. I was seeing the filament was struggling. This zero rainbow filament is not a high speed filament, so I had to tweak it a little bit. Probably I tweaked it too much. I'm pretty sure that's my mistake. But overall, look at this. It's like, it's a great print. Links, by the way, for this file will be in the description. I mean, I really love this model and I bought it for myself. Let's talk about PETG. I mean, let's address what I was really, really curious about. I mean, I use PETG a lot. And problem with PETG is that you need to print that slow. But this is not the case. I mean, I printed out stuff in PETG so fast, probably faster than PLA, and I was not expecting for that. I sliced it on CUDA, didn't touch the speed, left like the speed that CUDA was there as a profile, and results came out really nice. I mean, this is a calibration cube. Probably temperature here at the beginning was not right. I pumped it up a little bit and then it came great. Suggestion on the PETG purple goes from 220 to 240, and CUDA leaves 220 as standard, so I pumped it up to 235 in order for the PETG to flow in the best possible way. And I wanted to test stringing on this, and what surprised me is this print. This is a stringing test, guys. I mean, I don't know if you can see it, but there is no stringing whatsoever. And I'm talking about 235 degrees at a speed of 100, I think, 110. Can't actually remember what speed it was, but it was fast. PETG printing that fast really, really impressed me. And like, without losing any quality. I mean, this was printed in 2.0 layer, no issue whatsoever. Then I printed out some snowboards, hanger for the snowboard. I'm gonna put this on the wall on the other side and hang my snowboard. And they really look good. Like, they really look, the print looks nice. Last thing I printed in PETG was this hex spatula to take off objects from the plate. I saw the model, I liked it. And look at, like, I mean, it's really, really well printed. And this was printed in within like 35 minutes, I think. On a regular printer done in PLA, it would have taken more than an hour and a half. So we're taking time down at least half of the regular time you took. So, pros and cons of this 3D printer. Let's start from the pros. I mean, you've heard what I said. It's a really, really sturdy 3D printer. I loved it a lot. I loved the bed leveling system. I loved that you don't have to touch anything. You just mount that and run the bed leveling. That was amazing. I love the fact that they gave you a lot of spares. This never happens on a 3D printer. Of course, the Artillery and all the other brands give you spare parts, but the amount of spare parts that FL Sun gave you was kind of impressive. I mean, it was nice to have. It's nice to know that if anything breaks, I mean, I already have a replacement, and that's good. Thumbs up, FL Sun. Last but not least on the pros is the fact that I found a really large community online of FL Sun users, owners, and lovers of this printer. So it was very, very easy to get on the internet, find, like, pop up a question and have an answer after like a couple of minutes. So that's something I really, really loved. Getting on the cons. Let's start with the first cons that I didn't like. The first thing that they didn't like. As you can see, this is a very, very large printer, but the print volume is not that high. I mean, print volume is kind of less than the half of the entire height of the 3D printer. That's normal for a Delta 3D printer, because otherwise, where would the arms go? But nonetheless, the volume is like 260 by 330, so we're not talking about a very, very large volume of printer. But at the same time, it's like kind of huge. As you can see, it will not fit under my customized like bookshelf, like 3D printing farm. I've already talked about filament. Filament spool holder needs an upgrade. The upgrade I gave you, I will link you that file down in the description. You can print it and you will fix it. No issue will be found there. Last but not least is the fact that you cannot print TPU unless you go on a tweaking adventure. Changing extruder, modifying your hot end, probably even like shortening the Bowden tube or changing it to a much stiffer, a Capricorn one, for example. But I won't suggest you doing that. This printer is perfect for a beginner. I mean, I would really suggest it. I mean, I'm changing it, like, if you follow my videos, it's something I say often, this printer suits a beginner. And that's because I understand what being a beginner was, because I was a beginner a couple of years ago, and I know what makes my life easy. What makes my life easy is a 3D printer that you slice a piece, you put the end in the SD, once you have it all set up, you can leave the room and come back with a print here. First layer here never got mistaken. I mean, I always had first layer, and everybody knows that if you have a first layer, all the 3D print will be perfect. Let's run some conclusions. So for 250 euros, is this printer worth it? Hell yeah. I mean, you're getting an important 3D printer. I mean, it looks beautiful, by the way. I mean, I think Delta 3D printers are sexier than regular 3D printers. I mean, they're nice as well, but the Delta has that charm that the other 3D printers don't have. And for 250 euros, which is base price of a regular printer, you're getting a Delta, you're getting a Super Racer, even though it's 3 years old, but it's still worth it. And I mean, I could never suggest it more. Links are down in the description if you want to purchase it. Probably you can even add some coupons or stuff like that from Geek Buying. That was all for today, guys. I really hope you enjoyed the video. Smash the like button if you did like the video. Subscribe if you're not yet subscribed. And I'll see you guys on the next video.